Close encounter with a rabid cat. Thanks for staying with us tonight. I'm Bridget Shanahan. Tonight we hear from the father-son duo who found the bobcat holed up underneath their Clarendon home. That bobcat reportedly attacked several household cats in the neighborhood. A quick warning for you tonight. Some of these images you may find disturbing. WPTZ's Ashley Allen is live tonight in the Upper Valley Newsroom with continuing coverage of this story. Ashley?
Thanks, Bridget. You're right. You might want to avoid some of the pictures in this story. Last Saturday, Stephen Pomerleau and his son Stephen Pomerleau Jr. had an unwanted visitor at their Clarendon home on Cold River Road. A rabid bobcat wandered onto their property and snuck through a vent underneath their home, attacking multiple neighborhood cats that were keeping warm there. But I found out today that the cats weren't the only ones who suffered from the invasion.
Yeah, I'm not a big shot fan.
16-year-old Stephen Pomerleau Jr. stayed home from school on Thursday for an appointment to get his first rabies shot.
Each one's probably like, my mom told me, is like 3.5 to 4 inches big.
But he isn't the only one.
I just wish that when it did happen, and I told him I shot it, I wish somebody would have told me don't touch the animal, you know, and nobody told me that. So I got 6 people going to get shots for this.
Pomerleau's dad shot a rabid bobcat after it crawled underneath their Clarendon home.
I noticed the tracks were a lot bigger than a regular cat, and I figured it wasn't a regular cat. So at first, I didn't know it was a bobcat.
But then the Pomerleau's heard screams coming from the vents in their home.
And until it went underneath, and I heard it basically going after the other cats that were under there. It sounded like more of a dog growl, a loud, loud dog growl, but then it almost sounded like when it mix that in with the angry lady screaming. Put the both of them together, and that's basically what it sounded like.
And then we heard this, like, really loud, like, werewolf-type growl noise, and just, it was very vicious, and it was, like, it seemed really angry.
The father and son say they waited 5 hours for the bobcat to come out.
And I threw chicken out there to try to get it out.
And when it finally did, they got it. According to Stephen Pomerleau, 4 neighborhood cats were trapped under the house, along with the bobcat.
So what about the one that you heard it tear apart? Is that he was dead under your house?
I pulled it out. I pulled it out and sadly threw it out in the woods, you know.
The Pomerleaus told me that their family cat was also attacked on Saturday. Stephen Pomerleau Jr. said he pulled out an inch-long claw from his cat's eye. They're hoping it hasn't contracted rabies. In the Upper Valley Newsroom, Ashley Allen, WPTZ News Channel 5.